Our mission is to go out and patrol the seas undetected while carrying the weapons that our country needs.
This one ship has a lot of firepower. Some might even say this is one of the most powerful weapons in the U.S. arsenal, whether that's in any branch of the service. What are the capabilities of a submarine like this?
Well, the submarine is capable of launching the Trident II D5 missile, as well as the torpedoes that we showed you early in the torpedo room. Those are our primary weapons that we carry.
So if you never launched one of those missiles, that would be a success.
That's a great patrol. There's been thousands of successful patrols already in the United States Navy.
You showed us a drill today, an exercise in which you would be launching a ballistic missile from the submarine. What are the important parts of that drill? What were we looking at? Tell us what we were seeing when we were watching that drill.
What you're seeing is that part of the team, there's the process where we verify that those orders actually come from the president. There's the getting the ship in a condition that can support launch. There's verifying all the prerequisites and getting the missiles ready, getting them prepared for launch. It's all throughout the ship. The whole entire ship is preparing for that one evolution where we commence the actual launch. It can be anything from the ship itself being in position to verifying that the orders are true from the commanding officer, or correction, from the commander-in-chief.
Commander-in-chief. So I saw at one point somebody, there was a transfer of a key, or you were given a key and you put it around your neck. What was that key?
There is a launch key. I can't go into the specifics about what's required for me to get that, but we have a lot of positive measures that ensure that the orders that come are actually from the president. So before those keys are given to me, there's a very long chain of events that occur before I'm authorized to take those keys from the officers.
So you couldn't, if you wanted to, just get up one day and decide you were going to launch a missile?
Absolutely not.
And is there more than one key involved? Is there?
I can't go into the specifics, right. But they're under control. That is not through my access. I don't have access to them.
So one thing I've always wondered about is if you are waiting orders from the commander in chief, and yet you're invisible and underwater and no one can find you, are you still in communication
with
the National Command Authority even when you're deep at sea?
Absolutely. We have means available to stay in continuous communication. In fact, that's one of the things we provide the president. If they want to send orders to us, we can receive them immediately and carry them out. And that's part of what we do when we go on our patrol, is set ourselves up in a condition so that we can maintain continuous communications with the chain of command.
And can you tell us how that's done, or is that classified?
We have a wire that we can float behind us. It's just a long antenna that can receive broadcasts, and we use that. It'll float to the surface, and we can use that to receive long-range signals.
Now, have you ever thought about, and you must have because this is your job, but what would happen if this, you had to do this one time and it really wasn't a drill?
We do think about it. I mean, it's definitely not something we want to happen. Nobody in the boat wants it to happen, but it's important that we train for it, because if tasked, we're going to execute that mission.
So there's no doubt in your mind
about
that.
There is no doubt in my mind that we will execute it.
And how would, as a commander, how would you handle the crew on the boat after a launch like that, when no one would sort of know what the fate of the world would be hanging in the balance? How do you keep a crew together after that?
I'll tell you, that would be difficult. One of the reasons we train so frequently, the evolution you saw, we do that time and time again so that it becomes something that we can execute immediately and quickly. But after that would be a very difficult time. Hopefully we would be in continuous communications, like I talked about, and have some further guidance. But that's definitely one of those things where I can't tell you for sure what would happen after that.